Dear students, myself, Dr. Ritesh Kumar, Assistant Professor, Department of Geology, Government PG College, Ambala, Kent. Today, we shall discuss about topic on ecology and ecosystem. First, ecology, क्या होती है, ecology की क्या definition है? Ecology is derived from two Greek words, ecos and logos. Ecos means house or dwelling place. Logos means study of. Ecology can be defined as study of organism with respect to their house or dwelling place. Ecology, the scientific study of interaction between different organism and between organism and their environment or surrounding. Ernst Haeckel, a German geologist, coined the term ecology in 1866. After that, Danish botanist Eugenius Warming elaborated the idea of ecology. Basic concept of ecology. First, the fundamental idea behind the study of ecology is that all organisms are interdependent. Second one, they interact with one another and the physical environment. Objective of ecological study. First point, the interrelationship between organism in population and diverse communities. Second, the temporal sequential changes, seasonal, annual, and sectional, etc. Third one, structural adaptation and functional adjustment. The behavior under natural condition. Fifth, the development in the course of evolution. Sixth, the biological productivity and energy flow in natural system. Scope of ecology helps us to tackle problems like pollutions, floods, ozone depletions, global warming, and climate change. It is necessary in maintaining ecological balance and understanding different cycle, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, carbon, etc. helps in protecting flora and fauna. We can maintain balance in nature and can prevent ecological disasters. Plays an important role in human welfare, agriculture, conservations of wildlife. Factors of ecology. There is two factors that ecology study. First, the abiotic factor, non-living component, are those inert factors of the ecosystem, as the light, the temperature, the chemical products, the water, and the atmosphere. Second one is the biotic factor. Living organisms are all the living being in an environment. Ecology is study of interaction between non-living component in the environment, that is light, water, wind, nutrient in soil, heat, solar radiations, atmosphere, etc. Living organisms, plants, flora, animals, fauna, microorganisms in soil, etc. Terminology used in ecology: species, a uniform interbreeding population spreading over time and space is known as species. Community, a group of similar or dissimilar species living together under more or less similar environmental condition. Third one is the population. It is a group of similar community living together under similar environmental condition. Fourth, biome. The complex of several type of community that different stages of succession living together under similar environmental condition. Vegetation, a collective growth of plants in space is known as vegetation. Habitat, the place where an organism live or the place where one would go find a particular organism is known as habitat. Factor, any external force, substances or condition that affect the organism in any way is known as factor. Standing state, the total amount of inorganic substances, that is minerals such as phosphorus, sulfur, nitrogen, hydrogen, etc., present at any given time in the environment of an ecosystem is known as standing state. Biomass. Biomass is the total amount of living material present in the term of weight per unit area. Classification of ecology. Ecology can be classified based upon in the subdivisions as taxonomic affinity, plant ecology, and animal ecology. In early days of ecology, botanists and zoologists engaged themselves in the study of ecology of plants and animals respectively. This led to the development of such subdivisions as a plant ecology and animal ecology. Based on the habitat ecology, some ecologists thought of the study of habitat and their effect upon the organism. They selected a number of different habitat such as freshwater, grassland, forest, etc. This is then studied in detail for their possible relationship with the kind of organism present there. Such an approach led to the development of habitat ecology. Based on the level of organization, in this approach the organism involved in the ecology are either studied individually or in a group. Accordingly, they are classified as three categories: auto ecology, syn ecology, and habitat ecology. Auto ecology, it is also known as ecology of the individual's organisms. Syn ecology, it is also known as ecology of group of organisms. Classification of ecology, auto ecology, and syn ecology, it deals with the study of individuals, organisms, or an individual species. In other words, it is study of interrelationship between individual species or its population and environment, that is a tree in a forest. In ecology, it deals with the study of group of organisms or species which are associated together as a unit, that is a forest. It is concerned with the structure, nature, development of that community. Level of organization. Organism, populations, community, ecosystem, landscape, biomes, and ecosphere. Ecological interaction between organism. Competition. First, when two organisms of the same or different species attempt to use an ecological resource in the same place at the same time. Niche. The ecological niche involves both the place where an organism live and the roles that an organism has in its habitat. Elton, 1927. An ecological niche refers to animal place in the biotic environment and its relation to its food and enemies. Odom stated that the ecological niche has three aspects. First, septal or habitat niche, the actual physical space occupied by the organism. Second, trophic niche, functional position of the organism in the ecosystem. Third, hypervolume or multidimensional niche, position of the organism in the environmental gradients. Niche, a species in its unique functional role or place in an ecosystem. It is a description of all the biological, physical, and chemical factors that a species needs to survive, stay healthy, and reproduce. Its food niche, reproductive niche, are two types. For example, the ecological niche of a sunflower growing in the backyard includes absorbing light, water, nutrients for photosynthesis, providing shelter and food for other organisms, that is bees, ants, etc., and giving off oxygen into the atmosphere. The ecosystem and its components. Ecosystem, the attraction of the living organism and the non-living organism. Second, it is composed of biotic component such as plants, producers, animals, consumers, and the microorganisms, decomposers, and abiotic component which include air, water, soil, organic substances, climate, regime that are present in a given area. Major ecosystem. Earth is a vast ecosystem. It is, however, difficult to handle, and thus for convenience we generally study it by making artificial subdivision into unit of smaller ecosystem, that is terrestrial ecosystem, as forest ecosystem, desert ecosystem, grassland ecosystem, man-made ecosystem, and cropland ecosystem, and aquatic ecosystem as freshwater, marine etc. And ecosystem thus may be separated from each other, but it must be remembered that these units of ecosystems are linked with each other, forming an integrated system. Classification of ecosystem. Ecosystems are two types: natural ecosystem, artificial ecosystem. Natural ecosystems, two types: land ecosystem and aquatic ecosystem. Land ecosystems are three types: forest ecosystem, grassland ecosystem, deserts ecosystem. Aquatic ecosystem are three types: pond ecosystem, ocean ecosystem, and estuary ecosystem. Classification of ecosystem. Different type of ecosystem of biosphere artificially categorized as follows: natural ecosystem, artificial ecosystem. Natural ecosystem, these ecosystem operate by themselves under natural condition without any major interference by man, based upon the particular kind of habitat. These are further divided as terrestrial, as forest, grasslands and deserts, etc. Aquatic, which may be further distinguished as freshwater, which may be lotic running water as spring, stream and river, or limpid standing water as lakes, ponds, pool, ditch, swamps, etc. Marine ecosystem as an ocean or shallow one like sea or estuary, etc. Artificial ecosystem, these are maintained by man, where by addition of energy and plant manipulations, natural balance is disturbed regularly. For example, cropland like maize, wheat, rice field, etc., where man try to control the biotic community as well as physiochemical environment, or artificial ecosystem. Structure of ecosystem. A structure of ecosystem comprises of the composition of biological community, including species, number, biomass, life history, and distribution in space. The quantity and distribution of non-living material such as nutrient, water, etc. The range of condition for existence such as temperature, light, etc. Function of ecosystem. Function of ecosystem includes the rate of biological energy flow, that is production and respiration rate of the community. Third one is the rate of material or nutrient cycle. Fourth, biological or ecological regulation, including both regulation of organism by environment and regulation of environment by the organism. Component of an ecosystem. Each organism has two main components: abiotic or biotic. Abiotic component, the non-living factors or the physical environment prevailing in an ecosystem, forms abiotic component. Abiotic components are mainly two types. First, climatic factor. It includes rain, temperature, light, wind, humidity, etc. Adaptive factor, that is factor related to soil. It includes soil, pH, topography, minerals. Biotic component. The living organism includes plants, animals, and microorganisms in the ecosystems form biotic components. Biotic components are further classified into three main groups: producers, consumers, decomposers, or reducers. Producers, the green plants have chlorophyll with the help of which they are trap solar energy and change it into chemical energy of carbohydrates using simple inorganic compound, namely water and carbon dioxide. This process is known as photosynthesis. The chemical energy stored by the producers is utilized partially by the producers for their own growth and survival, and the remaining is stored in the plant for their future use. Consumers, the animals lack chlorophyll and are unable to synthesize their own food. Therefore, they depend on the producers for their food. They are known as heterotroph. Hetero means others, troph means feeder. The consumers are of four types: primary consumers, herbivores, that is animal feeding on plants, that is rabbit, deer, goat, etc. Secondary consumers, the animals feeding on herbivores are called secondary consumers or primary carnivores, that is cats, foxes, and snakes. Tertiary consumers, these are large carnivores which feed on secondary consumers, that is wolves. Quaternary consumers, they are also called omnivores. These are largest carnivores which feeds on tertiary consumers and are not eaten up by the other animals, that is lion and tiger. Component of an ecosystem. Decomposers, bacteria and fungi belong to this category. They break down the dead organic matter of producers and consumers for their food and release to the environment the simple inorganic and organic substance. These simple substances are reused by the producers, resulting in a cyclic change of material between biotic and abiotic environment. Component of an ecosystem. Component of an ecosystem: abiotic factor and biotic factor. Abiotic factor, climatic factor, edaphic factor. Biotic factor, three types: producers, consumers, decomposers. Or climatic factor, that is rain, temperature, light, wind. Edaphic factor, that is soil, pH, minerals, and topography. Producers, produce, that is green plants, autotrophs. Consumers, primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary, heterotroph. Decomposers, that is bacteria and fungi, saprotrophs. Food chain and food web. Food chain kya hoti hai? In food chain, each organism eats the smaller organism and is eaten by the larger ones. All those organisms which are interlinked with each other through food together constitute the ecosystem. The different level in a food chains are called trophic level. Each food chain has three main topic level: producer level, consumer levels, and decomposer level. If any of the intermediate stage of the food chain is removed, the succeeding link to the food chain will be affected. The arrangement in a food chain can be depicted as type of food chains, grazing food chains. This type of food chain starts from living green plants, goes to grazing herbivores and onto carnivores. Ecosystem with such type of food chain directly depend upon the solar energy for their food requirements. Most of the ecosystem in nature follows this type of food chain. Detritus food chain. This type of food chain goes from dead organic matter onto the microorganisms and then to the organism feeding on detritus and their predators. Such ecosystems are less dependent on direct solar energy. Parasitic food chain. This type of food chain starts from big host and with parasitic organisms. Food web kya hoti hai? The interconnected interlocking pattern of food chain is known as food web. Under natural condition of the linear arrangement of food chains hardly occur and they remain interconnected with each other through different type of organism and different levels, such as interconnected and interlocking pattern of food chain is known as food web. Food web are foxes, rabbits, squirrels, mice, seed eating birds, herbivore insects, and hawks and foxes, etc. A food web illustrates all the possible transfers of nutrients and energy among the organisms in an ecosystem. The food chain exhibits only one pathway in the food web. A food web may be quite complex as it involves a wide variety of organisms. The stability of community is maintained even if one or more chain of the web are changed. Thus, a food web provide stability to ecosystem, and higher is the number of its component, more stable will be the ecosystem. Energy flow in an ecosystem. Biological activity require energy, which ultimately comes from the sun. Solar energy is transformed into chemical energy by a process of photosynthesis. This energy is stored in plant tissue and then transformed into heat energy during metabolic activities. Thus, in biological words, the energy flow from the sun to plants and then all heterotrophic organisms. The flow of energy is unidirectional and non-cyclic. This one-way flow of energy is governed by laws of thermodynamics, which states that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed, but may be transformed from one form to another. During the energy transfer, there is degradation of energy from a concentrator from chemical or electrical, etc., to a dispersed form heat. No energy transformation is 100% efficient. It is always by some dispersion or loss of energy in the form of heat. Therefore, biological system, including ecosystem, must be supplied with energy on a continuous basis. Energy flow in an ecosystem: sun producers, consumers, decomposers, inorganic nutrient pool. Diagram is shown. Ecological pyramids, the different species in a food chain are called trophic levels. Each food chain has three main trophic levels: producers, consumers, and decomposers. Thus, graphical representations of these trophic level is called as ecological pyramids. It was devised by an ecologist, Charles Elton. Therefore, these pyramids are also called ecological pyramids or Eltonian pyramids. Thank you. This is all about the topic ecology and ecosystem. Okay, dear students, thanking you for watching and listening my topic.